To me, innovation means taking something new, unique to you, and bringing it forward. And hopefully that can impact the world. I would describe the paths of excellence as a way for you to be able to pick something that's really interesting to you and have the support of the university and the medical school, as well as some chunk of time carved out within the third and fourth year of medical school to be able to go and do it. What drew me to medicine is I went into special forces in the US Army, and one of the specialties on the team was as a medic. I wanted to be a medic because I wanted to be able to help somebody if something bad happened, and that was the first step toward the path of medicine. The US military was having discovered that they had a problem with a lot of soldiers who were dying what they call preventable deaths, meaning they didn't have to die if somebody was there who knew what they were doing. The problem was the only people who were trained at the time were doctors, nurses, medics, like me. So the way they found a solution to that was what they ended up calling tactical combat casualty care. And that's basically, in a nutshell, is training everybody at a very baseline with the knowledge and skills of what to do to save a life. Once I was leaving active duty, coming back home and thinking, why isn't this something we do here? I have the knowledge and skills, I've been training people to do this. That's what got me involved in Path of Excellence and Innovation and Entrepreneurship and starting the project, what I called the First Five, Emergency Response for Everyone. The idea being, what do you do in the first 5 minutes of a medical emergency when the ambulance is on the way? The typical path when people think innovation, entrepreneurship, especially in medicine, is what they call diagnostics and therapeutics. So my idea did not fit that at all, but it actually wasn't a stumbling block. I found support for that, both within this path of excellence and in the broader medical school community. So the problem is I had no business background, no experience in starting a company or making a startup or anything like that. It can feel overwhelming if you have that blank slate and say, well, here's my idea, how do we implement it? You have to create a business model, you have to find your customer discovery, you have to find what is the gap that you are trying to fill, who else is already out there trying to fill that, and how are you different or better? So one of the first big things is you need other people, you need a team. For me, that was other members of the post-bac program who were also studying for medical school that had a background as being an EMT. Another was in the Navy and was also an EMT. So we had some shared experiences and we all had a passion for making this real. And so from that, we started a company and made a startup, made our business model, did some different competitions through Optimize and through the School of Public Health's Innovation in Action. We made business pitches and we actually raised over $10,000 in funding for our project. The main mission of the First Five is to teach everyday people who are bystanders to a medical emergency what to do in those initial few minutes after an injury strikes, to bridge that gap before the ambulance arrives. What we do is we'll run these two-hour hands-on workshops. They have realistic scenarios and they're tailored to each group. So it's not like every group is just getting the exact same thing. We make sure to cover really important things like stopping major bleeding, making sure somebody can breathe, CPR and AED if they don't have a pulse. But we also want to know, what do you want to learn? What situation have you been in real life, or do you fear being caught in and you don't know what to do? Having just those knowledge and skills, you could really save a lot of lives. I would not have tried to start a company or try to implement the idea without a path of innovation and entrepreneurship. I think that is the key, is that being told that if you have a good idea, you can make something of it, that's innovation. You can find resources, you can find mentors, and you can turn it into something real. I think residencies want to see medical students who are not just smart, but also want to make a difference and have shown through a capstone for impact that all of us will do through the path of excellence, that you have made a difference. Something that can really impact people all across the country and the world.